And so the first track we're gonna start off with is let's see, I gotta get to my playlist. Is called "Fuck It Off" by T Grizzly. So this actually has Chris Brown in it, and it's from his album "Activated," which came out in the summer at some point. He was actually on Peter Rosenberg's show on Complex, which was called "Open Late with Peter Rosenberg."
Okay. That's like a live series, right? Like,
yeah.
Is it on YouTube? Like, you know,
it's on
you
YouTube,
it?
Yeah. Okay. So like you'll like when you watch it, it's live. It's a YouTube series, so right. You can watch it live on YouTube when he does it. I think okay. He's still doing it. He's on his second season now, and it's actually pretty cool. He's gotten a lot of really like big artists, and like they have really cool conversations about just hip hop in general. And it's cool to see like artists come together and talk about people other than themselves. Like I think right. That's really cool to hear like Joey Badass talk about hip hop at large, or like issues that are going on hip hop. I think that's really cool.
Yeah.
So this is called "Fuck It Off" by T Grizzly featuring Chris Brown.
Who you think you finna play with? Who you think you finna run your mouth to and won't say shit? I'm out chip. When it's cold, are you out there? Them bullets hot, think not, get your mouth chip. Hella niggas talk shit, but they stand still. Let's take a trip, duct tape, how the van feel. $100,000 Cartiers, I'ma change shit. Keep playing with Liu Kang, I'ma kick it to your main bitch. And I've been fucking hoes on my base shit. Come to the crib, I tell her go to the spaceship. Red pill, blue pill, we in the matrix. Take it to the face, better do what I say, bitch. He make it out of here, then he a winner. If a nigga try to run, then we pull up in sprinters. We get the bustin' at your bucket, fuck it, hit your liver. End of discussion, there's nothing, I eat you pussies for dinner. I got no time for fake ones. Killers on the west side with them real guns. And if you try to wear the white flag, we gon' still come.
Where you at here, nigga?
All this pussy, I'ma drill some.
Why they hate to see a real nigga make it? I done made a lot of change, now my people changing. By myself, I don't need no witness. Can't think nobody but the Lord, cause I'm getting it. I keep my head up and middle finger to the sky. And living every fucking day like it's Mardi Gras. I'ma finesse this shit, win, lose, or draw. You think I worked this hard to fuck it
up? Once again, I gotta remind these niggas. Balenciaga, remember when I couldn't buy these, nigga? Call them bricks birds, cause we really fly these bitches. Tell your mans I know I'm lit, but don't eye me, nigga. I'm solving every single problem with a tool. Super soaker nigga like he jumping off the pool. Let the feds hit the mansion, we gon' make it to the news. Chop a lifting nigga up, I bet he make it to the moon. You can tell me and Breezy at the top. They want us to fail, hoping that we fall, but we not. Don't feel bad for what I did to them niggas block. Can't say what happened, just know I had to get rid of the Glock. Remember my league days, couldn't pull a bitch days. Now I ain't tripping on none of the bills, that shit paid. Niggas tryna fake beef with a nigga that's just hate. Sneak this, see me, y'all jump on my dick, these niggas lame. Hey, niggas terrible, who raised y'all? Niggas leeches, I can't feed them, I can't baby y'all. I'm giving headshots, all ain't about to fade y'all. Bitch, you ain't fucking by Felicia, I can't play with y'all.
Why they hate to see a real nigga make it? I done made a lot of change, now my people changing. By myself, I don't need no witness. Can't think nobody but the Lord, cause I'm getting it. I keep my head up and middle finger to the sky. And living every fucking day like it's Mardi Gras. I'ma finesse this shit, win, lose, or draw. You think I worked this hard to fuck it up?
Alright, so that was Fuck It Off featuring Chris Brown and T Grizzly. And we were just talking about, we're amazed that Chris Brown is still like relevant, given all the controversies that have like come from just his career, like the Rihanna thing, obviously.
Yeah, then, I mean, but it's not just that, right? It's like that, like the Carucci thing, like.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got a lot of controversies, but sort of MJ.
Yeah.
And I like the talent is undeniable.
Oh, for sure.
And so it's like, I don't know. It kind of goes like it's another prime example of like, do you separate the art from the artist kind of question.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. I think that there are artists like who have done less that have been sort of like shunned. Less than him that have been sort of shunned from the music and like they don't just from like canceled, quote unquote.
Oh, okay. I see,
that have done like far less than what Chris Brown did. I mean, because Chris Brown's like consistently doing like messed
up
stuff.
So I think that like part of it is that like, so take like X for example, X is X-Concussion. So I heard about him before I heard about all the stuff he did.
Yeah.
So I listened to 17 and I was like, wow, this is a really good album. And then at that point, if you had asked me, I'd be like, yeah, I guess I'm a fan technically of X. and then I found out like all the things that happened.
Yeah.
So it was hard because it was like, well, I've already formed this like opinion in my head of liking of his music and, and thinking that he's a really talented guy, which, independent of what he does in his personal life, is true that he was talented.
Yeah.
So it's like, at that point, it's hard to be like, oh, I'm just never gonna listen to them again. Like, oh, I'm never gonna like watch anything of theirs again. Like, and so like, what I ended up doing essentially was, like, after that, like, I didn't pay attention to a lot of his releases because I didn't agree with like how he was like as a person. But that still didn't change the fact that I'd still go back and listen to 17 because I'd already heard it and decided that I liked it before I found out about other stuff. So like with Chris Brown, like, I mean, he stretches all the way back to 2006.
Oh yeah.
Right. So I mean, he already had hits on hits on hits.
Yeah.
By the time the Rihanna thing happened. Then had more hits on hits on hits by the time the Caruso situation happened. So, like, there's a lot of people that, like, really fell in love with Chris Brown before all the bad stuff happened. And then once stuff like that does come out, it's really hard for people who are huge fans to just drop him all of a sudden.
Yeah.
You know, it's like if it came out tomorrow that, like, Kid Cudi did something, like, really heinous or something, like, I feel like it'd be really hard for me to, like, completely just be like, oh, like, I'm never gonna like listen to him.
Yeah,
I'm never because I'm such a huge fan of him at this point. It's like, you know. So
yeah, he had like wall to wall. Probably like Chris Brown slapped back in the day. I remember seeing a tweet that said like Chris Brown had like 500 unreleased songs, and then everybody was like, "Yo, keep it." Like, we don't want to hear that. All right, so this next song is called "Replace" by Jay Critch off his new album Hood Favorite.
Yeah, so Jay Critch just released an album. I heard of him because he's part of he had a tape recently with a couple other people, but I don't remember who it was. I think it was Rich the Kid and Famous Dex, I think. They all had a tape together. So that's like kind of how I first heard of him. And then he released this very recently, and a couple of my friends were talking about it, so I decided to give it a listen. It's okay, but the track that we're playing here I thought was a standout. So he had some like all-star features on there, but like nothing that really like set it off like in any way. Like, he had Offset, French Montana, but nothing that really like made the tape itself like worth listening to like more than once, I'd say.
Okay.
But this song was a standout. So.
Cool. Let's get it.
Turn me up.
Hey.
Took money gang.
Damn, turn me up.
Hey,
I'm in the rave, feeling like I'm out of space. Hey, I blow a bag, then you know it get replaced. Wait, diamonds go ape shit, making you cover your face. Hey, shorty just take dick. I don't take her on a date. They always frontin', I'm on to something. I just made a play for the green. I need an award or something. We all be stuntin', I'm breaking bread with the team. We got it all from nothing. The hoes is coming, they know the money with me. Check out the stones, that's a lot of EV. I'm on the road like I popped a bean. My shooters don't pass, they jacking from deep. You can't get a pass, stop jacking the team. Spend five on the bag, my jacket costs three. I give me the bag, then I gotta leave. Hey, I don't care what you saying, I don't know you. Diamonds going Super Saiyan like Goku. Young nigga make a lot of bands off of Pro Tools. Niggas jerking off the flip phone like it's O2. And I gotta keep it real, keep it old school. Niggas saying that they will, but they won't do. Had to do it for the hills, what I told you. I was in the chicken spot, now it's Nobu. And we going worldwide, but you're local. Just chill out, you niggas too heavy. Quit capping, you niggas ain't ready. The Jetic is giving me headaches. But my pinky ring look like confetti. Fuck a hoe, I just want me some cake. The strap is closed, mama told me be safe. I had to go, put the racks in the safe.
Hey,
I'm in the rave, feeling like I'm out of space. Hey, I blow a bag, then you know it get replaced. Wait, diamonds go ape shit, making you cover your face. Hey, shorty just take dick. I don't take her on a date. They always frontin', I'm on to something. I just made a play for the green. I need an award or something. We all be stuntin', I'm breaking bread with the team. We got it all from nothing. The hoes is coming, they know the money with me. Check out the stones, that's a lot of EV. I'm on the road like I popped a bean. That's a fact, pockets full with the G's. Watch your back, block 100 degrees. I don't do shit for free, they paying a fee. I'm flexing hard, gotta watch what I eat. Diamonds shine like they brushing their teeth. Dancing like tutus, new whip with the moon roof. All of my niggas connected like Bluetooth. Niggas broke, they better go get a Blues Clues. I'll be first to that money and you lose. I'll be first to that money and you lose. The bankroll hundreds is true blues. If she sucking me right, get her new shoes. Tell her hold a toolie, cause I got a lay low. Might put the bitch on the payroll. I had rips in my nudies, now I got the bankroll. Might catch a flight to Tobago. Hood fave, I stay talking about a check. Pockets correct.
Hood fave.
I been bowling, keep my foot on they neck. Pussy boy calling attack. She keep calling, but I told her just put it to rest. Shorty, I'm on to the next.
Cool brain, like she taking a guess.
Money long range, I be making it stretch. Get the cheese, what's the hold up?
Hold up.
Make some plays off of that Motorola. Green on me like I'm Yoda. Said she wanna taste, wanna sip of the soda. New chain, heavy, feel like a boulder. The Rari sick, like the shit got Ebola. My necklace is stacking up, it's getting cold. Like Tetris, I stack it up till it's game over.
Game over.
Ayy. I'm in the Wraith, feeling like I'm out of space.
Ayy,
I blow a bag, then you know it get replaced.
Place.
Wait, diamonds go ape shit, making you cover your face.
Ayy,
shorty just take dick.
Hey.
I don't take her on a date.
They always frontin', I'm on to something. I just made a play for the green.
I need an award or something. We all be stuntin', I'm breaking bread with the team. We got it all from nothing. Our hoes is coming, they know the money with me. Check out the stones, that's a lot of VV. I'm on the roll like I popped a bean.
All right, so that was Replaced by Jay Critch.
Yes.
This next track is off an album called Redemption by J-Rock. It's called Win. I'm just kidding.
I was about to leave, bro. I was about to leave the studio.
The song is called ES Tales, which was my favorite track from the album. I wasn't a big fan of the album Redemption, and like everyone, all the critics were like, there's nothing redeeming about this album. It's like the typical like criticism of it.
Yeah.
This is like making fun of the title.
Yeah.
And it wasn't as good as like 90059 or like his previous work. So like
Awesome was good though.
Yeah.
And I think it's funny, like I've seen like Anthony Fantano several times, like when he reviews music, that when there's like somebody who's featured twice, he'll like talk about how like one is like better than the other, or like he'll compare them directly, and sometimes it's like, yeah, this person's featured twice and one of them was very clearly better than the other collab. I feel that way about the Kendrick feature.
Yeah.
Because he was on the freestyle one.
Wow Freestyle.
Wow Freestyle.
Yeah.
And that one was so much better than Win.
Yeah. It's Win. So Win is the closing track and it's like one of the worst songs like just ever.
Would
like,
you say it's one of the worst songs of 2018?
Yeah. Like I really would. I don't understand how that hook like
passed.
Yeah, I really don't.
I mean, TDE as a collective is kind of notorious for not having the greatest hooks.
Yeah.
But that's like, not even like not the greatest. That's just like straight up.
Yeah,
bad.
This is bad. Yeah.
Yeah.
So this is ES Tales by J-Rock. Let's get it.
Back in the projects, I lost it all. Now I'm back in the projects.
Hardcore drugs, everything crooked, what you thought this was. Scheme plot, turn powder in a rock. Plan goes sour, that's how you get got. Aw, oh, shit, got it popping in the bricks. Product painful, now it's time to get rich. Keep in mind, never walk around blind.
All that back and forth gets me high sometimes. Wanna see somebody get knocked out, just box one time, shit. Catch a fade, it ain't nothing. Get your head up at the gym, bring your knuckles. Look, I'm deep inside the projects, where's Bracken at? You know the zip, where we take a quarter piece, flip it, tell a corner lit. A1 Yola, that fresh over the border shit. Shootouts and abortion situations, so unfortunate. I know a nigga doing double digits, bust a head wide for another nigga who's scared to rip his set right. Now solitary, doing push-ups by his bedside. All he want is a green dot, his homie keeping himself fly. Don't come around without your pass, niggas on they tip. Zero tolerance on niggas' money, niggas want they shit. Don't start nothing without your blower, that's a one-way trip. 6 feet under real life, that's all gunplay.
Yeah, that hood shit with young niggas on that misunderstood shit. Jumping out of smoking rentals, caves with the wood grips. Bitches for them bank statements to come and hit a full split. Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch?
niggas John Jack and they ain't on that hood shit. Bitch, we bout that action on that wish you would shit. All red flags, swag on 10. We ain't in the club, we can't get our goods in. So we in the hood, situations look grim. One time circling for colors of your skin. Black lives matter out here, no way. Cops get promotions while the family gotta pray. It's fucked up, can't explain babies all in a dump truck. It's all about that money, man. Miss me with that Trump stuff. Trying to make a dollar out of 15. Don't get fucked up, it's shaking the bag. You get a bug, then you lucked up. You faking, you mad. You got an issue, you get fucked up. Get laid on your ass. You feeling bad, your blunt's crushed up. We in the set, just bicking it like the Cosby's. Trying to get dope, live happy days like Chachi. If you get a call from Poppy, that's like Jesus calling. All you do is execute, next 10 seasons ballin'. You can get the world, stay loyal, why you even trip? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch? Don't you know no good, don't you know no good, bitch?
All right, and that was ES Tales by J-Rock.
Yeah. Shout out to our producer of the day, DJ Khaled. It's funny because, like, he, you know, he technically, like, quote-unquote executive produces all of his albums.
Yeah.
So he has, if you actually, like, look through the credits, he has production credits on each album. I don't know how much of it he actually does.
Right.
But, I mean, he has earned his chops as a producer in general because he goes stretches back to, like, the 90s.
Yeah, and he used to, like, I mean, he's a DJ. Like, he actually can spin records. Like, yeah, there's videos of him, like, really going in on the turntables.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
He's really good. But then he had to retire the name Terror Squad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you see his stage dive?
Oh, yeah, and like, they didn't.
Yeah, it was
it's
like,
kinda like
nah,
moved out
right.
the way slowly.
Yeah.
It was so funny.
But yeah, DJ Khaled he really does have an eye for like what will sound good and like what mixes really well.
I mean, the thing is, like, if you look at producers that today like don't really like produce anymore, these kind of direct, like the talent that it takes to get to the level where you can direct like that, like they like you have to do a lot of actual production or you're like Diddy, Dre, DJ Khaled, Kanye, all of them, they don't really do a lot of, like, actual behind-the-board stuff. They're just like, oh, like, take the sound out, put the sound in, or, like, change this melody here.
Yeah.
But the thing is, like, those little details are what makes songs hits.
Yeah.
And so, like,
100%.
You know.
And, like, being able to get, like, I could not have been, okay, Chris Brown, or Quavo, Justin Bieber, Lil Wayne, and like put I couldn't think of that.
Yeah.
But like it worked really well.
Yeah. Or like if you gave me like an upcoming track by like like Chris Brown or something like that, and you just like let me listen to it, and you're like, oh, like do you like it? And like if it was a good track, I'd be like, yeah. Like I don't think I'd have the ear to be like, actually, like that little detail right there,
right.
Change it to this, and like instead of the drums here, like put them like right there.
Yeah.
And then it'll be a hit. And then you know.
Yeah. Definitely a talented guy. And it's funny that he was like a meme like 2 years ago, and now his meme. I think people just got tired of. Like the like major key stuff is like, all right, bro, like we get it. So the next track we got is called Location Remote by Currency, Freddie Gibbs, and The Alchemist.
Yeah, so they just released a collab album called Fetty, which I think is a brand. But yeah, so like, I mean, Currency, I've been a huge fan of for a while, and I was surprised to see him work with Freddie Gibbs.
Yeah.
Because like their styles, at least recently, I would argue, are pretty different.
Very different.
But I think they gel. And I think it kind of sounds like Currency kind of getting back to his roots a little bit. Like kind of his old stuff. So
I actually have two Freddie Gibbs tracks and a Currency track on here. So
oh, wow.
It's interesting.
So a lot of Freddie and Currency today.
Yeah. Because Freddie released an album called Freddie, or a mixtape, or EP, or whatever.
Yeah.
And it's okay. So this is Location Remote.
Remote. Ivory Coast, trying to get high as I could go. The glass ceiling broke, it's never over. Soul controller, all I chains golder. Diamonds brighter, you ain't got an ex who liver. Niggas dying to be like us, losing their minds, trying. I'm in the basement scraping blades with all my sharpening irons. Cause in times of peace, that's when these snake niggas creep. You think you safe cause you deep, your goon is half sleep. Stooges if you ask me. Gibbs and Andretti fill that vault full of Fetty. Andretti and Gibbs, that's like that barrel to your rib. Is that fucking real?
East side.
Something special.
Nigga, fuck East side. Hey, yo, call the chiropractor. This necklace is extra heavy on me. 1963 gold D's, I went Andretti on it. Did the shoes in 24 carats and dropped the Chevy on it. Boss, fuck a franchise tag. Niggas can't levy on me. Yeah. Cause of a bitch, I had to sit the bench. L-Train, bless me, you broke me off when I hit the bricks. Passing off the dog, bitch, I score the dope and I get assist. Kidnapping, IG trapping, might get your sister hit. We taping mamas up, we filling them llamas up. Niggas making statements, they man a Fort Papadopoulos. Trump sweating bullets on Diet Coke, sniffing powder up. And if he build a wall, we gon' bring that dope underground with us. Told my niggas, spit of your enemies, my enemies. I just sold the power of the Model X, real nigga, keep the same energy. Like what? I rap the pack like a stunner man. Legend in this bitch might do Coachella as a hologram, nigga.
That is just exactly what they want you to believe. Let's just call it phenomenal.
He outranks them. He outranks them.
I don't want to sit. I want my money.
I'm like shit, yeah, bitch, yeah. I got my first paycheck, quit my job, let's get some yay today. Mama in the struggle, had to put my shit on layaway. Once they got a taste of that white fake, boy, they can stay away. Emptied out my 4-5, hit them with that MJ fade away. Fresh up off a thing, it's I'm Freddy Kane. Gangsta ain't no snitching on my name, that's on Larry Jane. Now 22, one news, bitch, I'm insane. With that on the gang, it gave you with that yoga flame. Don't stay in your lane, bitch, yeah. Whippin' what I'm chippin' straight off the brick, yeah. Arm and hammer with the chicken, I'm too legit, yeah. Ain't no whippin' what I'm chippin' straight off the brick, yeah. Arm and hammer with the chicken, I'm too legit, yeah. Ain't no whippin' what I'm chippin' straight off the brick, yeah. Arm and hammer with the chicken, I'm too legit, yeah. Ain't no whippin' what I'm chippin' straight off the brick, yeah.
Fuck that bullshit, motherfucker. Oh, motherfucker wanna slap me with some dollars.
All right, so that last track was Too Legit by Freddie Gibbs off his new album, Freddie. And I was first attracted to that song from the sample in the back. It's a fairly quiet synth, that he uses. He actually does this with a few of the tracks on the mixtape. He samples or references through the lyrics or through his cadence songs from like West Coast back in the day, like when NWA started coming up. That sample was used. It's a song called My Life. And it was featured in Straight Outta Compton in a scene where Dr. Dre is like lying down on the ground listening to the song My Life. Yeah. And he's like thinking of how to sing.
The title is Everybody Loves the Sunshine.
Loves the Sunshine, yes.
They repeat My Life a lot, though.
Yeah.
But apparently that song has been, so I just looked it up. It's been sampled in 129 songs.
Yeah.
That one.
Yeah.
But it's a really good song.
And Dre sampled it in a song called My Life. That's why I was thinking.
Yeah, he did. Yep.
So, yeah, I think that was pretty cool that Freddie used it. This next track we got is off the new Action Bronson album. It's White Bronco.
White Bronco.
The title track, right?
Yep. Yeah. So, he released this this past Friday. I think it was this past Friday. There was a lot of stuff that dropped this past Friday.
Oh, yeah. There's been a lot
and,
of stuff.
I mean, like, November in general is going to be a big month for hip-hop releases. I know, like, Spino's dropping this Friday. Like, a lot of people are dropping. So, I listened to some of Action Bronson's record. I like Action Bronson overall, but I don't listen to his music that often. Mm-hmm. But I usually listen to his albums at least once through. And this is, like, one of the standouts for me. It's the title track, actually.
Yeah.
So, it's called White Bronco. The track is called White Bronco. And he has like a couple of cool features on the album, but none on this song. But he does a good job with it.
Sweet. And that was White Bronco by Action Bronson. I'm very curious to listen to that album because I've always liked what I've heard from Action Bronson. He's a very unique artist. This next track is from a guy named Nick Grant, who came out with an album.
Didn't he come here? Like to Maryland?
Maybe he did.
Yeah,
he's like,
he did.
He's like up and coming. I think he's been on one of the XXL freshman cover or freshman freestyles or maybe a BET cypher or something. And he came out with... Damn, you had to put this instrumental on. he came out with an album, I think, 2 years ago called Return to the Cool that I really liked a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And then he came out with an album this year called Dreaming Out Loud, which I also liked. And this song is called Blue Cheese, featuring B. Hess. And It's a pretty good song, and it has a good vocal hook feature. So yeah. This is Nick Grant, Blue Cheese.
I wake up and get in my bag.
My bag, yeah.
I count up my cash. I pray up my soul.
My soul.
Then go and get more.
Get more, yeah. Yeah.
I wake up and get in my bag.
My bag.
My bitch is so bad.
From and time. I hit it soon as
I wake up and get in my bag.
My bag, yeah.
I count up my cash. I pray up my soul.
My soul.
Then go and get more.
Get more, yeah. Yeah.
I wake up. Right in my bag,
yeah, yeah.
I dream about racks. I gotta get in as soon as I wake up. I wake up, yeah.
You done fell in love with the bad guy. Tell him I ain't nothing like your last guy. Feeling like Harden with the stash spot. Hit it like Ricky with the bag shots. Looking for a way out. So you know I bought a crib way out. You know a young nigga about the dope boy. I'm so real when I let the tray out. Yeah, put that on game. Better yet, let me put you on game. The way this little bitch take D, I call that shit still in my slang. Fuck boy, I'm still in my bag. Nigga can't stop flipping this cash. Got the glow and the pippin' in my jeans. If it's it, then I'm all on the ass. By the green light, Jimmy with the mask. Pulling off and I gotta do the dash. Still you only getting money for the cab. Mike Jack moonwalk for
I
a bag, yeah.
And get in my bag.
My bag, yeah.
I count up my cash. I pray up my soul,
my soul.
Then go and get more,
get more, yeah. Yeah.
I wake up
yeah.
And get in my bag.
My bag.
My bitch is so bad.
Oh,
and I hit it soon as I wake up
yeah.
And get in my bag.
My bag, yeah.
I count up my cash. I pray up my soul,
my soul.
Then go and get more,
get more, yeah. Yeah.
I wake up
yeah.
Get right in my bag, yeah. I dream about racks.
Oh,
I gotta get in as soon as I wake up. I wake up, yeah.
I wake up. I wake up.
Tell me why my ex keep blowing me. Swear, nigga, mama used to warn me. I'ma make a kill and get the corner. Like it's prime time on the corner. Fucking with the plug, we connected. You know I blew cheese, how I'm dressing. How they got the white jumping out the pot. Somebody need to go and talk to Wesley. All my niggas is the realest. All you niggas in your feelings. Copper feel I hit the ceiling. Oh, that's been a disappearance. Oh, you wish you had this willpower. Getting jiggy with it, I'm that nigga. Who ain't the realest? Shit, I'm offended. 10 on the window, bitch, mind your business. She gon' shake ass, she gon' bounce some titties. That pussy brown like a golden penny. And these niggas tell on they co-defendants. Catch you slipping while you on the move. Sorry, I might need a quote for minutes. Eyes popping out the coupe, nigga. I'm coming strong as a bowl of spinach. Never, ever, ever waste time. When you devoted, just go and get it.
Wait. I wake up and get in my bag.
My bag, yeah.
I count up my cash. I pray up my soul.
My soul.
Then go and get more.
Get more, yeah. Yeah.
I wake up.
As soon as I
wake up and get in my bag.
My bag, yeah.
I count up my cash. I pray up my soul.
My soul.
Then go and get more.
Get more, yeah. Yeah.
I wake up.
Get
right in my bag. Yeah. I dream about racks. I gotta get in as soon as I wake up. I wake up. Yeah.
I wake up. I wake up.
Alright, and that was Blue Cheese by Nick Grant. Now, this next track is off an album that just dropped on Friday, I guess as well, called FM by Vince
Staples.
Yeah,
Vince Staples, yeah.
And the song is called Relay.
Yeah, this album had a lot of, like, Bay Area influence, actually. Like, some of the, like, the tracks kind of sound like, kind of like... E, like, I guess, like, E-40, like, S-O-B-R-B-E,
okay.
Kind of, like, sound
great.
To it. Which is, like, interesting for Vince. I mean, it works, because he's really versatile.
Yeah.
This is actually one of the only tracks that doesn't sound like that. Because, if I'm being honest, like, I wasn't a huge fan of that sound. like, I don't know, like, it's cool, but like, I don't want to, I was like looking forward to, I guess, like, I don't know if I expected another Big Fish Theory.
Yeah.
But also, like, a lot of his music in general, it, like, this sounds very different from anything he's done before. And, like, a lot of people said that about Big Fish Theory, which I actually disagreed with. Mm. I thought Big Fish Theory was very in line for a lot of Vince Staples' earlier music, and I would say that this is not.
Okay.
For better or for worse. So.
Yeah. I mean, SOB and RBE, like, they have really good, like, sounds, and, like, I like their sound, if only their, like, flow was better. Like, I don't like their flow at all. I think it's so bad.
He did this chopper making
save. So, yeah, I guess we'll see how this Vince album is. Have you heard the whole thing?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
I mean, it's only, what, 30 minutes long?
Really?
It's, like, it's 10 tracks in, like, 20-something minutes.
So that's the trend. That really is the trend now.
I guess.
Really short album.
Yeah, it makes it easier to listen to everything.
I know DJ Booth was, like, super in favor of that, and they were, like, and I know I've had arguments with DJ Booth over things.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't know how I feel about it. I feel like...
I think everybody's album should be 7 tracks like Kanye.
Yeah. 7 tracks, 24 minutes. I mean, Internet did it too. He was like, hey,
yeah, he did.
I want to be like Kanye, so. I feel like, I guess, if you can get what all you need to say out in shorter than a half hour or whatever it is, then, like, obviously, like, go for it. But I think part of what I consider to be an album is, like, a lengthy, like, dedication.
Like an LP, not an EP.
Yeah, and, like, you have to actually, like, part of the album is, like, you know, a cohesiveness, right? Like, that's right. That's why we have the album format, is that it's assumed that most of, if not all, the songs have something to do with each other. Or
right.
And then also that it's not just, like, why, like, could I make a 3-track album that's, like, only 15 minutes long? It's like, well, I don't know, because to me, an album is something where you actually have to sit down and dedicate a decent amount of time to listen to and dive into the concepts on the
album. That's fair.
So,
I mean, I think that, like, for, like, the honestly, the biggest drawback for me on these short album trend is that there's no room for error at all.
Yeah.
If there's even one track on there that, like, shouldn't be, mm-hmm. it, like, really messes up the entire album in a way.
Yeah.
Because, like, you only have 25 minutes. So if 5 of those minutes are spent on something that I don't like, that's, like, a fifth of your album, right?
Yeah.
Whereas, like, if you have 16 tracks and there's a track that I don't particularly like, it's fine. Because I can skip it, and maybe given
ones.
The surrounding tracks and the context of that within the album, mm-hmm. it may grow on me.
Yeah,
so
for
you
sure.
know, like, I feel like there's definitely merit to having a longer album. I mean, the short albums, like, if you can do it, like you said, like, more power to you.
Yeah.
And there have been some great 7-track albums. Like, Pusha T's album was amazing.
Yeah,
and so, like, you know, Kid C Ghost was a 10. So
okay, all right. So this is Relay by Vince Staples.
Chirp on Skinner. Got blurt with the hammer. Y'all ain't playing with the DA. I'm finna hit the counter, do a relay. Fed chirp on Skinner. Got blurt with the hammer. Y'all ain't playing with the DA. I'm finna hit the counter, do a relay. Do you really wanna know about some gangsta shit? In the city, sitting pretty west, dang you, bitch. Why me talk that bunch of Carter, that Karanga shit? Watch your back of boarding crackers, try to hang you quick. Baby, let me break the levees, I'ma hit the spot. It be tricky when that bitch you get you, get you got. She so pretty in the face, ass titties in the waist. Pull up trying to get a taste, and she get you back. Fed chirp on Skinner. Got blurred with the hammer. Y'all ain't playing with the DA. I'm finna hit the counter, do a relay. Chirp on Skinner. Got blurt with the hammer. Y'all ain't playing with the DA. I'm finna hit the counter, do a relay. Baby went to Howard, got a BA. Had her baby shower in the PJs. Got her baby daddy for a GTA. On the GTL trying to beat the case. Crimey kept inside, at least that's what he say. From direct deposit to the lawyer plate. Around and take the stand on her dude. He gon' have to raise his baby from the visiting room. Fed chirp on Skinner. Got blurt with the hammer. Y'all ain't playing with the DA. I'm finna hit the counter, do a relay. Fed chirp on Skinner. Got blurt with the hammer. Y'all ain't playing with the DA. I'm finna hit the counter, do a relay.
Keep listening. listening for your chance to win tickets to see Kehlani live. Hit us up, 562-453-9382.
Why did he put that in the song?
it's called FM, okay. Right? Which yeah, like radio. But I wonder, like, if he got the influence from Tyler. Because I know he and Tyler, the Creator, are really good friends.
Yeah.
Like, he was almost in Odd Future, actually, Vince Staples.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because they met back when he was on Earl's first tape.
Okay.
And that was back in, like, 2009 or something like that. That was, like, before Odd Future was Odd Future. So, like, I mean, he's been friends with them for a long time. And on Flower Boy and on Cherry Bomb, I think, he had, like, little, like, skits that would be like, oh, like, and this is Golf Radio. You're listening to blah, blah, blah. Like, phone in for your chance. So, like, I don't know. Maybe you got that kind of influence from
him. Yeah, sure. This next track is by Currency and Harry Fraud off their little collab tape, The Marina. And it's a song called Scarab 38 featuring Action Bronson, actually. And have you heard the tape, The Marina?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, it's okay. I wasn't like head over heels, but I thought I wasn't bad.
Yeah.
Which is how I feel about a lot of Currency's music. I know you're a big fan of him.
Yeah, he just has so much output. Like,
it's so much.
So, it's like hard.
And a lot of it sort of like, to me, like merges into just like a general sound. Like a lot of it's similar, very similar. But I thought this track was pretty cool, and I thought Action Bronson had a good participation on the track. So this is Scarab 38 by Currency.
I'm ready. Take me up.
La música de Harry Fraud.
Amethyst and quartz, different types of burning nerves. Ask to keep all of these demons out the room, yeah. 50 racks on heady glass to reach a higher ground. DMT inside the teepee, I think I'm higher now. Hearing lions growl while I'm lying down. Play connected dots with constellations while I'm flying around this multicolored dream world. This ain't SeaWorld, but similar. Make it 3D twirl, just seen a Puerto Rican zebra. It's the age of Sagittarius. Archers on chariots. Large money hanging the balance. Like the Intercontinental Belt at SummerSlam. Razor Ramon versus Shawn Michaels, part two, bitch.
Overlooking the veranda, me and my private dancer. My brains like John Stark, she walked through the castle like Sansa. I took major chances to land us in this position, where the engines mounted in the back of us. The streets chatter of us coming up. It's like they glad to see the gladiators papered up. It was a prophecy fulfilled, I raise your glasses up. They chill properly, imported and stored until an occasional rose. Celebrate, we get dough, another open dough, another closed, another meal, another deal. And once the ink dry, you worth upwards of 20 mil. And in the blink of an eye, you who them bitches feel. This shit is really real. Matter of fact, this shit is really ill. But I wouldn't choose another lifestyle still. Paddle shift the F1 gears, go uphill. I got a stupid ass crib up there, I stay here. Yeah.
There are several large packages, large bundles. These look more suspicious.
Yeah, he's just turning south.
No, he's going into the inlet.
Yep, straight in.
Yeah, and I got got a whole bunch of people on the beach waiting for him, at least 10 people.
They're definitely beached.
They're unloading fuel barrels.
Yeah, they're unloading the barrels.
All right, and that was Scarab 38 by Action Bronson and Currency.
Yeah.
So Cameron and I have been talking about the Pusha T and Drake beef for the last, like, 2 days, and whether there's a line in hip-hop that can be crossed with beefs, because Hip Hop DX came out with a video recently, like a week ago.
Yeah, I was like, is there a line?
Yeah, is there a line in hip-hop? And so what is your opinion on it?
So my opinion, I was saying, is basically, like, My line gets drawn when you start bringing in people who aren't part of the beef. So, for example, like the Pusha T Drake beef, right? Like, Pusha, he came at Drake for the ghostwriting on Infrared, mm-hmm. right? He also came at Lil Wayne, right? But that's still okay because Pusha T and Lil Wayne have a historic beef with each other. So sure. He's still not, like, bringing people into it that, like, don't have anything to do with it. Then Drake responds and brings Pusha T's wife into it, right? Well, like, yeah. He, like, mentions her, which actually still, I would have said, doesn't cross the line. Because he said, I'm going to let it ring like Virginia Williams. Which is just basically, like, a play on the fact that he put a ring on her hand. Like, it's not, like, a diss toward the wife.
Yeah.
But then when Pusha was, like, OVO 40 on Stover, like, he's 80. Like, yeah. That crossed the line to me because it's, like, 40 is just chilling in his house. Like, he has nothing to do.
And he's a producer, too.
Yeah, he's a producer. Like, he doesn't rap. Like, he's basically defenseless. Yeah. He's, like, take a shot at him for no reason. You know? And it's, like, Jordan and I were talking, and then Jordan kind of posed a question. So then, like, when Biggie said that, or when Tupac said that he had sex with Biggie's wife, was that crossing the line? And my opinion was no, because that's not a diss at Faith Evans. Because, like, that's just saying we had sex. That's not a diss.
Okay,
but
yeah.
It's only a diss because Biggie exists, and it's a shot toward him.
Okay.
So, like, as long as you're not bringing other people into it, I think that, like, anything flies.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about when Tupac on Hit 'Em Up at the very end said, like, and if Mobb Deep want it, like, don't one of y'all have sickle cell? Like, that was sort of unrelated to, like, what the song was about.
Yeah.
Is that too far?
I would say yes. Because, like, there's no reason, unless you're, like, trying to start beef with someone, like, I mean, I guess it's, like, a little different because, like, Mobb Deep, like, are rappers. But, like, still, like, I mean, that had nothing to do, really, with, like, anything else. He's kind of, like, put it in there. And it's, like, why?
Okay, but had it been a diss towards Mobb Deep, like, the track itself, and he said something about sickle cell in it, you don't think that's crossing the line?
So, I would say no. Even though, so I wouldn't, if I was in a frat beef with someone, I don't think I could say something like that.
Yeah.
But, like, if you're trying to, I don't know. It's, like, it's a really foul line.
Yeah.
Like saying, like, don't want to have sickle cells, like, it's pretty bad.
But, so, I guess my, like, crossing the line would be, is it something that we as a community should condemn? Be like, this is not what we want in hip-hop. Because I think that's where, like, what is a line, right? Like, obviously people will cross lines all the time and, like, they don't care because what are we going to do about it? But I think that generally people in the hip-hop community do not censor, but, like, a lot of their content may be what's acceptable, may depend on what's acceptable in the community because they just have respect for the community and the respect for the culture.
Yeah. So I think that, I mean, I guess it's kind of harks to, like, you could bring in, like, Eminem's beef with, like, everyone, but, like, specifically Tyler and the line where he, like, basically came for Tyler just for being gay.
Sure.
And it's like, does that cross the line?
Mm-hmm.
And I think it, like, depends on your view. So, like, again, like, I guess technically under my definition, I wouldn't be crossing a line, even though I would never, like, say something like that.
Yeah.
And I guess I could see why people would draw the line there. But it's, like, the only line you could draw is basically saying, like, you can't take shots at someone for things that they can't help.
Okay.
Right? But we do that all the time. Right? Like, for things, like, we make fun of people for things they can't help all the time. And, like, it's not, usually it's not things as drastic as, like, having sickle cell or, like, being gay. But, like, we still do it. So, like, to say, like, you can't make fun of anybody for anything they can't help, then banishes, like, everything else.
Like, your nose is whack.
Yeah, like, something like that. Like, I don't know. Like if Drake was, like, rapping against, like, Pusha T and then was, like, something, like, I don't even.
Or, like, when Nas made fun of Jay-Z for having, like no beard or, like, just, like, a little bit of stubble.
Yeah.
Like, that was, like,
yeah, like, there's nothing Jay-Z can do about that to, like, grow more facial hair. But, like, he, like, you still make fun of it, right?
Okay, So my opinion that I sort of came up with in the last hour when I was doing Ben's show was if we've decided as a community and as a culture that we don't want hip-hop to extend beyond the music and actually cause people to fight and kill each other.
Right.
Because we have decided that. Like, that is the premise. And the reason that we've decided that is because life is precious and we don't want music to get so personal to the point where we're killing each other. Then why is life no longer precious when talking about when the violence against somebody's life or the threat of somebody's life is not for being perpetrated by us, rather a disease or a disorder that somebody has. So if we value life and that's why we don't want to kill each other anymore because it's not that deep, then why is it okay to make fun of something that's killing someone else, which is MS or sickle cell, even though it's not us, it's still somebody like losing their life.
That's true.
And the same thing with the Capstees disc from Troy Ave. And I think that we've decided that that's not okay because you're making fun of someone who's dying or dead. And that goes along the same vein as physically going and trying to hurt someone or kill someone, to me.
Okay.
So that's kind of like where I would draw the line. I mean, that's not to say that the only thing that's not acceptable is making fun of someone's dying. Like, obviously, like when Ja Rule went for Haley Mathers, that was messed up.
That crossed the line. Yeah. Like, she has nothing to do with that.
Yeah. Dude. He said, like, your mom is an addict and Kim is a known slut. So what do you think Haley's going to be when she grows up?
Yeah.
And then he had Haley on a track. Have you ever heard Haley's Revenge?
Yeah.
And he literally has Haley on the track. And he says, Haley, what do you want to be when you grow up? And she says, I don't know, but I don't want to be anything like Ja Rule's dirty ass kids. She like, said that, like that. Yeah. Haley, that like, is we, so like, savage.
Like, but like, you don't need that. Like, you don't, like, no, why are you bringing
your kids? No.
To, like,
at that point, that is not crossing the line because.
Well, no, because the line was already crossed.
Yeah,
on,
you're
on
retaliating.
M&M.
Yeah. Like, that's, yeah.
But I'm just saying, like, why did, like, Ja Rule cross the line there?
Oh, 100%.
Because, like, that, like, there's no reason to bring
a kid like, into a young
it.
Kid. Yeah.
And, like, especially when the kid doesn't have anything to do with the rap beef. Like, if the beef was between Ja Rule and Haley.
Yeah.
Then, like, all right,
wow,
go, like, go
your
for
mom's
it.
A slut.
Like, yeah, go for it. But. It's not between him. It's like between him and Eminem. So like, leave it alone. You know, like, yeah.
So, back to the music. So the next track we got is called Reginald by Mick Jenkins featuring Ben Hixon.
Yeah, it's got a really like bouncy beat to it, and it's like a pretty cool flow. My only knock against Pieces of a Man was that a lot of it sounded the same, like throughout the like within the context of the album. And so I was like, well, I wish I like had a little bit more variation. Like Grace and Mercy was like a nice break from like the smoother sounds that were like going on, and like, you know, then it kind of hops back into that. Or like Hair on Flow Part 2 was like super like jazzy. It was like straight jazz, like a drum set and like everything. And like they play it actually on Green Dolphin Street. I noticed that.
Oh wow.
Cool.
Nice.
Yeah, so I thought that was like a nice variation. But then like a lot of the other tracks were just kind of like a really like jazzy mellow synth over like some kind of like boom bappy drums, and like it was good. But I just like after listening to so many of those tracks in a row, you're like,
yeah,
you kind of forget you're listening to music.
So do you think it's better than the Healing Component or no? Because I really like the Healing Component. I thought that was a great album.
I don't think Pieces of a Man is better than the Healing Component. I actually think just off of like full projects, so not counting Waves because that's an EP,
mm-hmm.
I would say Pieces of a Man is probably his worst.
Okay.
That's not to say it's bad.
Yeah.
It's just like the other ones were better. Yeah.
Sure.
So.
All right. Let's get it.
But Reginald is really good.
What you wanna do? Hey, feeling like that nigga. These days my skin is much clearer. My woman's skin is much clearer. Of course I'm drinking my water. Don't spend too much time in mirrors. Reflections that get you caught up. Connections that get you brought up in conversation. You basing everything you know about me from moments. I'm more a compilation or composition. It's complicated. I've contemplated so many perspectives. Accommodated. My vices exonerated. Emotions. And then I'm coping. Macaulay Culkin. I'm trapping my demons over Bohemian Rhapsody. They draw lines and I widow's peak. We don't peak in capacity. Casually giving no fucks about your two cents. We gon' clip the loose ends. We gon' clip the split ends. We gon' split ends. We gon' burn the nooses. They tried to exclude us. They lied to include us. My tribe is of Judah. Your kind is of Judas. I ordered this season no Brutus. Among us uprooting the fungus. These niggas is leeches. They learned it all from us. They run. Don't forget to counting up another nigga dough. Don't call me a hater just because I wasn't fucking with the flow. If it's Reggie, then I gotta let you know. Keep it that real, niggas already know. Don't you get to counting up another nigga dough. Don't call me a hater just because I wasn't fucking with the flow. If it's Reggie, then I gotta let you know. That real, niggas already do. What you wanna do about me telling the truth? I get it, you sensitive, and I don't say that with malice. My intentions are pensive and poignant. Opinions annoying as they are often informing. I'm critically thinking, I'm fixing my form and my shooting percentages rising. I worked on my vertical simply by just switching horizons. Collided my will with the wave, and niggas call me Poseidon. Just call me the plug. I'm providing the drugs in small doses. We grinding, we rolling, we smoking, we cooking, we eating, refocus, repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat till it's polished. Acknowledge my genius. No
college degree on me. Got a few G's with me, got a OZ on me. It's some OG, homie, don't you count the paper on me. Don't you get to counting up another nigga dough. Don't call me a hater just because I wasn't fucking with the flow. If it's Reggie, then I gotta let you know. Keep it that real, niggas already know. Don't you get to counting up another nigga dough. Don't call me a hater just because I wasn't fucking with the flow. If it's Reggie, then I gotta let you, know. That real niggas already.
All right, that was Reginald by Mick Jenkins.
Yes.
We got two more tracks for you guys. The first one is Pretending featuring Jesse Reyes by A Boogie With A Hoodie from his mixtape International Artist.
Who now, is you might Jesse Reyes?
Because she's a singer. She's on the Eminem album twice, actually. Yeah. But the last, it was like
one of which was
Nice Guy and
a lot better than the other.
Yeah, 100%. She has a really interesting voice, and she reminds me a lot of Bebe Borelli in that her voice is like very like sharp and like borderline out of tune, but like in a, I guess in a creative good way. It's not like orthodox.
She kind of reminds me of Charlie XCX.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Their voices are a little similar, yeah.
Yeah, and I thought this was... A Boogie With The Hoodie, I've never listened to a project by him, but he released this International Artist mixtape, and I was like, all right, I'll take a listen. And
I
like,
almost saw him in concert, actually.
Really?
Yeah, because he was supposed to open for... He was supposed to open for Anderson .Paak, remember?
Oh, yeah.
And then he didn't show up.
Yeah,
for whatever
we were like,
reason.
Bro, where's A Boogie For The Hoodie?
Yeah.
And he just wasn't there.
Yeah.
And there's like a few dancehall tracks on this project. There's a song called Deja Vu, which there's another rapper named Boogie who also has a song called Deja Vu. And I was like, wow, this is Deja Vu. Cause I feel like I just heard this by the same guy, but they're different people. Apparently Boogie is actually signed to, Shady Records. I think
Boogie or A Boogie?
Boogie, just okay. Boogie. And then I don't know what A Boogie is, signed to, but he's like kind of been blowing up the last few years. So. This is Pretending by A Boogie With The Hoodie.
Yes, I've been drinking. Yes, I'm pretending that I don't need your love. It's been a long week. Don't try to stop me. Don't stop till the liquor's done.
Sorry if I don't pick up. I was off that 42 and yeah, I'm still fucked up. I'm just like you, you're just like me, and they're all just like us. I was only 13, Aki's let me buy my Dutch. I need that Derrick, about to go and get that Lambo truck. Skirt off, try to murk a state, might get murked first. I got a fox up in my coat and they got real fox fur. It's 5 a.m. and I've been drinking, so my words might slur, yeah.
Yes, I've been drinking. Yes, I'm pretending that I don't need your love. It's been a long week. Don't try to stop me. Don't stop till the liquor's done. I don't need blessing. I'm a flexing and buying for everyone. Yes, I've been drinking. Yes, I'm pretending my baby won't pick up.
Probably think we pretending they won't believe us. Creeping and hoping nobody seen us. Let me show you how like every pair sneaker. But every time I saw you, I would freeze up. If I write you more than once, would I be beastin'? Fuck a triple date, let's have a threesome. Fuck you in your face, may have you leaking. She love my diamond chains, all my pieces.
Yes, I've been drinking. I don't need blessing. I'm a flexing and buying for everyone.
DJ Khaled produce this?
He co-produced it.
Tough.
So, yeah.
This is a great song. All right, so the last track we got for you guys is called Feels Like Summer by Vince Staples off his new FM.
Yeah, so you'll definitely hear what I mean when I say it's like very kind of like Northern Cali inspired when you hear this song. It's the opening track on it. Cool. But yeah.
Sweet. All right, thanks for listening, guys. Guys, it's been In the Creases.
Feels like summer.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? It always feels like summer in the neighborhood, man. When you get a chance to come in, get a chance to lay back, you get a chance to laugh, you get a chance to chill. Best believe that, man. And being that it always feels like summer, let's go ahead and make you feel like summer.
Summertime in the LB wild, we gon' party till the sun or the guns come out. JB first one fouled out playing ball, now the whole city love you or how. Boy, we know they wasn't down from the get-go. Dirty got a dozen rounds, better get low. Lil Johnny gave his life for the shit. All he got was a plot and a bottle from the Winco. Still no side, park side, been stole. Two wins, no friends, we skip those. Try finessing my way in the heaven. Might hit that gate, might fall from a great splat. On the concrete, real street runner. First month still feel like summer. Cold weather won't stop, no gunner. Wrong hat, wrong day, I kill my brother.
Ay, summertime in the LB, Lord, I ain't shit a bro, nigga gon' tell me now. Drop top with the top down, now all the bad bitches gon' feel me now. Ay, oh, oh.
Take from it, hey. White fans at the Coachella, hey. Never been touched, niggas know better, hey. Same way since summer school, baby J. Either I'ma make the news or make a play. Passing Lisa House, coulda took a different route. Wouldn't be without, think about it every day. Moved on life fast like that. Still struggle with the past, I ain't strapped. Somebody gotta watch my back. Everybody wanna count my bag. Ease off me, these streets taught me. Speak softly, please don't taunt me. Knowing Vic and them stay don't.